What's up, happy people, and welcome back to Tip Lady Catch and Release. So today is Sunday, and that means it is the verse of the week. So our verse comes from Revelation 2, 9 through 10. And this verse has such power behind it, and here's what it says. It says, I know about your suffering and your poverty, but you are rich. I know the blasphemy of those opposing you. They say they are Christians, but they are not, because their churches belong to Satan. Don't be afraid of what you are about to suffer. The devil will throw some of you into the prison to test you. You will suffer for 10 days, but if you remain faithful, even when facing death, I will give you a crown of life. Wow, that verse is so powerful. And when I read that verse, it makes me think of Philippians 2:10, where it says, at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. Everyone will praise his name. I'm going to praise his name. You're going to praise his name. Your friend's going to praise his name. And when it says under the earth, that means the devil. One day, the devil will praise Jesus's name. And I can tell y'all this, that day is soon. That day is coming. So get ready. Put your faith and your trust in Jesus. Extol his name with praise, for he is worthy of it. When you praise him, that'll make the devil mad, and he'll try and harm you for it. But don't lose hope. Just keep praising God. See, the devil knows your weak spots, but he also knows that the one that is in you is greater than whatever you're carrying. So give God praise for that. He is greater. Give him praise. For on that last day, when Jesus comes back, he will defeat the devil for once and for all. Just call on the name of Jesus. When you say, the one that created me is greater than the one that is facing me. When you say, the one that created me gave his life to redeem me from the shame that is on me. Now I can stand up like a new creation. I can stand up like a child of God. I can stand up like a spirit-filled, blood-bought, devil-chasing, Satan-facing, overcoming child of the Most High God. Tell the devil, try it again. Try it again, I'll call Jesus. Try it again, he'll send an army of angels. Try it again, and I'll drown you in the Red Sea of my troubles. So get up and walk. Get up and move forward. Get up. Come on, somebody. Somebody needs to hear me today. You need to get up and leave your past behind and step into the plan and the future that God has for you. Worship the Lord. Magnify the Lord's name, because your praise is powerful. I believe he will do it again for you. He will part the water for you. He will have the walls fall down in front of you. Nothing can hold back the power of Jesus. Not even death itself can hold back the power of him. So why are we letting little things get to us, and harm the plan and the purpose that God has for us, when all we need to do is call on Jesus' name, for he is bigger than our battle, for the battle belongs to him. And he has never lost a battle, and he is never going to lose a battle. Let's not wait to praise God until he comes back. Let's praise him for all he's doing now. Let's praise him and extol his name and worship him now. In Psalms 43, it says, he gave me a new song of praise, a song to extol his name with praise. He is worthy of our praise. So Christians, let's extol his name. Let's lift him up and magnify the Lord's name. For he is good to us. He is kind to us. He will protect us. He will save us from whatever we're carrying. Just trust in the Lord, and he will do exceedingly more than you think will happen. So thank you for watching Tip Lady Catch and Release. Make sure to tune in next Sunday for another verse of the week. Take care. God bless. And we are gone.
See you next time, guys!